Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today, me and my husband are going to run to PA to go to Ikea for the first time. Mm-hmm. At Home Store, Half Price Books.
Trader Joe's. And the greatest restaurant in the history of the world.
The Indian restaurant.
Taj Mahal.
And we thought we would take you along for our journey, so let's go. First stop was a local coffee shop. I got me a sugar-free vanilla bliss latte with oat milk, and he got...
Oh, an iced Americano. That's my go-to drink.
So, cheers to a fun, great day.
Cheers.
We have arrived to IKEA. Here we go. We didn't bring tape measure. Look how pretty that is. They're like cabinets.
Oh, I see the little
lake. Yeah. I really love this kids setup where they have the curtain rug with the paper. They kind of call it the art studio. And then the little window with the curtains. These bookshelves. I like these bookshelves, Jake. With the cabinets. But you can see this is called Life with Kids, and they have all the stuff that they created at the art studio. Jacob found his new day bed.
I didn't even know a day bed was a thing, honestly. So like, this is just a bed.
Yeah, a twin bed.
I like it.
You like the colors of this room too, because you like it dark and moody. Jacob also likes this for his library. What? These are all the love seats too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this whole section is living rooms. We love the shelf going along the bottom. What do you think of this kitchen?
I like it. I even like a wallpaper.
I do not, but...
Maybe because I only watched that one show. Design, whatever it is.
And then you can see the living room.
Not thinking about aesthetic.
We're also looking for new bed frames.
This one doesn't have the drawers.
No, it doesn't have the drawers. So that prevents the cat from going underneath it then. And that one only has drawers on one side. So we have to have drawers on two sides. Like this one. I think we found the bed frame we like. It is $300, but it is upholstery, drawers, so the cat cannot get anywhere.
And it's low to the ground.
And it's low to the ground, which Jacob likes.
Statistically speaking, 500 people a year die from falling off the bed.
We're not old yet.
This one, that won't happen.
True. And it's made, it says on the back that it's a post word for soft reading in bed and breakfast in bed.
Listen, the two B's that I like, breakfast and books.
So there we go. I think we may have found it. I like the two sinks. We can have our own bathroom. Look at these drawers. I love this store. Stop to get lunch at the Swedish restaurant. Jacob's going to try Swedish meatballs for us.
Well, I'm going to do it live on camera?
Yep.
You know what? It's definitely a
meatball. All right, we went through the showroom, we ate some lunch, now we're going to go down to the marketplace. What are your thoughts so far?
It's pretty big.
It's big, it's and I'm weird. A little overwhelmed. So we're gonna go downstairs now.
Are you overstimulated?
Yeah, stimulates me right here. Down we go. Did you find your seat? Do you want to get for your man cave?
I think so. I think you just want me to completely redesign my office so you can make me do a refresh.
I want him to redo all of his bookshelves to all match, but he likes the cozy, all the different types of thrifted look.
The hodgepodge stuff.
This would look good with the chair, the blanket that you love. First thoughts on IKEA?
I liked it. I think there's a lot of reasonable priced items in there, like I think bookshelves, tables, that kind of stuff. But the chairs were really expensive, and they weren't that comfortable. But I did get a chair, and it was the most comfortable chair in the whole place. I tried them all, and it was on clearance for $130. So I don't know what that's about. Now, we were going to get the bed frame.
Yes. But someone looked at reviews while we were eating lunch, and they were very negative reviews, so we've decided just to wait and do some more research on a bed frame.
Yeah, it was like, it squeaks after a month.
So, and we don't want a squeaky bed.
And then they said the headboard wasn't
secure enough.
Yeah, it wobbled.
It wobbles, which I could have felt that when I was filling it. I've noticed that.
Yeah, and I thought it was just because it was a floor model, but
I liked it. It was a little overstimulating for me just because there was so much to look at and I didn't know what to do. And
so
I was vlogging
colors.
For the first time in a store. Maybe IKEA wasn't the store to do that because there was a lot of people, so many colors, so many things to look at. But we did get some good stuff and we will do a haul either tomorrow when we get back or tonight.
And now we're going to go
to at-home store.
Or Joanne.
No, we're going to at-home first. We're not going to go Joanne's.
Well, I need Starbucks.
We're going to Starbucks then at-home.
Or a Dunkin' would be fine too.
All right, off we go.
Are you excited to go to the at-home superstore?
Yes, I am. I've never been to an at-home superstore, just an at-home.
I wonder what makes it so super.
Because it looks like it's humongous.
Oh, joy. You can tell by my voice that I'm thrilled.
We are leaving the at-home superstore. I loved it. I got what I needed. Did you like it?
I don't like it. Every furniture store is ruined now after we went to IKEA.
So, he's a fan of IKEA now, so.
Aesthetics-wise.
Aesthetics-wise, yes. IKEA's aesthetics was awesome. I came for at home to get a tree, but once I saw it, I didn't really like it, so I didn't get it.
Well, I don't see the point of a tree.
It's going to take up room. And we have a cat, he's going to eat it. You need to take right.
All right. Because if we have a lot of space, right? Oh, a tree's gonna be fine. But we don't have a limited space or anything, but I don't know.
Yeah, so I didn't get it. So, but I thought I would save the money to actually get the chair I want. So I figured that was a better purchase.
Poitches.
But I did get a sign for above the TV.
Chair, please. Someone poitches the chair.
All right, guys, we'll see you when we get to Half Price Books. We had to take a detour route because there was an accident. So, a little farther way out, but we didn't have to sit in traffic for 30 minutes. So here we go. There's a PNC Park. the crazy bustle of traffic. This is why he's driving. Going into Half Price Books with a tote of books to see if they'll take them. Okay, I found the perfect game for you.
Okay.
What?
It's the Great American Mail Race. Congratulations, you now work for the USPS. Oof. And you have to prove you're the best mail carrier in town. Well, that's... I don't need this game. I already am. Using official USPS transportation, including steamboats, hot air balloons, and even a rocket, your mission is to deliver as much mail as possible to some of America's best named towns. Oh, it even has, like, possum neck, elephant butt, or big bottom. Oh, my goodness. Make a delivery stamp. Stamp your sheet. Well, I don't need this game, because I do it every day.
Where are we at?
We are at the greatest restaurant in America, Taj Mahal. And you know what? You're not gonna believe this, but they serve Indian food.
Are you hungry?
I think I got about 5 plates in me.
Ready to go in?
I'm ready to go in. I'm ready to get some butter chicken.
Off we go. All right, we left Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal.
And then we got our Starbucks, and now we're going to Trader Joe's. We are finally home. The dog is excited to see us, so we're going to unpack Trader Joe's. We will catch you back up with you in the morning because we are super tired.
Oh my goodness.
See you in the morning. It is the next day. Are you rested?
I'm well rested.
You're well rested. We got a cup of coffee and we're going to go through our hauls with you. So we're going to start with IKEA first. So we got... You got 6 wine glasses.
Because I keep using the same Merry Christmas wine glass you got from Dollar Tree.
And there they are.
I think it's high time to actually get wine glasses.
Okay, move those to the left of you. And then we got stainless steel measuring cups and measuring spoons. A bamboo
spatula.
Spatula.
Yeah.
And then we got stainless steel spatula, ladle, and spaghetti.
So you want to get away from using plastic utensils.
Yes. And then we got a new colander that goes onto the sink. It's kind of cool.
Right. That's something I've wanted for a long time.
And then we got 2 black shelves to put beside of a coffee bar to put my coffee mugs, because I have too many.
These things are ready to put together, right?
Yeah, you just got to hang on the wall.
Okay. because you had those lung things.
Now, I don't know if there's any screws with them, but we'll figure it out when we open it.
Yeah, I think there's right there, so. We'll figure it out.
Figure it out. If not, we can go to Walmart and get screws. All right. Then we got two Ikea's, the natural wood for our nightstands in the bedroom.
This is what it looks like right here.
Yes. I'll look at the picture. Okay, and then...
And we were going to get the whole thing, but if you...
Oh, yeah.
If you've never been to Ikea, it's not like Walmart where you go get the box and then everything's in there. You have to get the box and then also the brace where it hangs up on. And they were out of that brace. We had to go to Amazon and do it.
Yes. And then he got his chair, which we will show when it's fully put together on
a wall or something. This one looks like right here. I didn't even go shopping for a chair.
No, you didn't. You just found one. So, and I ordered my new chair last night at the Indian restaurant. So now let's do an at-home haul. So I got...
Are you going to post another video about that?
What?
That new chair, or are you going to put it in this video?
Probably post a new video. And then I got this for the living room when I do summer decorations, because I do bees. And then I've been looking for a sign to put above the TV. And I love this one that it says, "Every family has a story, welcome to ours."
I'm just glad it doesn't say live, laugh, love.
And then what else did we get from my home? Oh yeah, I got some flowers to put on those shelves.
Did you get a vase?
I did. It's in here somewhere. It's all wrapped up. And I got this to put on my tear tray. I'm going to unscrew the pole.
Your tear tray?
Yeah. I'm going to unscrew the pole.
What's a tear tray?
By this kitchen sink.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that was called a tear tray.
Yeah.
Oh, tell them what happened with the coffee mug in IKEA.
We were going to buy a coffee mug at IKEA, but he had used it to make sure it would fit on the shelves and he left it laying there.
I traveled all the way over to get the coffee mug, make sure that it fit on the railing that we got, and we forgot to bring the mug with us.
Yeah. That's okay. I got sticky. Got just a plain Easter egg to decorate with.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah. And then, I think this is the vase. I didn't realize they taped everything, guys. And this is the vase that I got with the flowers.
Are those the flowers that I picked out?
I had them, yeah.
You gave me two options?
Yeah, they're Lily of the Valleys. And then I got a spring candle, which I'm usually not into carrot cakes, but this is an iced carrot cake, and it smells delicious.
It doesn't even smell like carrot cake to me. It smells like s'mores. You know. Oh, never played this, buddy.
Alright. Now we're going to do our half-price book haul.
Oh, boy.
Alright. I got the most books, so. I got 7 Days of Us, which was $1. This is a Christmas book. I got another Christmas book called Christmas at the Carrotons. It's kind of like a handbags department store. I got Christmas at the Fireside Cabins. This was also $1. I got Debbie McComber's A Cedar Cove Christmas because I'm trying to collect all her Cedar Coves to finish that whole 13 book series.
You might have it.
I might have it. I wasn't sure, but it was $1.
You have so many books, it's kind of tell which one you have.
Little Pieces of Me was $8.49. He'll Be Mine, which was $7.99. This one I'm really excited for. Wildwood Whisper.
Well, that Oh, that one's got two.
And then the last two, and then we got one to share.
Yeah.
When I'm Dead, this is was $7, and this was an October 2023 book of the month. And then the last one I got was The Girlfriend. And it was $7.99. And now Jacob's Hall.
Well, let's do the one that we got together.
On the very bottom.
Oh. Bret Easton Ellis's The Shards. I was actually kind of surprised that you were...
We'll see.
...interested in this book. I heard it's really good. I've... Oh, that's funny. They used a young photo of him. He's not that young anymore. But I've read... Less Than Zero before, and I really enjoyed it. I tried reading American Psycho, and I just wasn't in the mood for that kind of book. But this is the newest one, and it got for half price. Would you believe it? So there's that. Let's see. I couldn't believe I found this. Young Mongo by Douglas Stewart, who wrote Shuggie Bane, and there's a critic that I always look to see what they say about certain books, and this was one of the books that was the best of this year, the year that came out, which I think is, 2022. It's an Irish writer, and I'm pretty sure Douglas Stewart is an Irish writer, and I love Irish writers. Something about them, I love how they write. I've never read an Irish book that I didn't like. I got a CD, REM's On a Mac for the People. I just like having CDs sometimes. And On a Mac for the People, I've not read or listened to this one yet. So I like REM. I've listened to all the other stuff. I haven't listened to that one. The Hyena and the Hawk by Adrian, I can't say his last name. Can you say his last name? Well, it's covered by the sticker. Oh, there we go.
No, I'm not going to try.
Can you try?
Ducky Bosky?
That's honestly probably what his last name is, but he's a fantasy writer. And I was looking for one of his other books, and I couldn't find it.
That's book three, you know.
Is it really?
See the three?
Oh my god, I do that every single time. Well, I'm putting this in a little free library. Now I gotta find out what the first one is of this.
I think they're in the back.
What's this? Oh, yes. This is a... what is this? Ramage by Dudley Pope. The Lord Ramage novels, number one. See, I made sure it was number one. This is just a historical, nautical fiction. Where did it take place? It doesn't say what century, but I'd guess probably like 1700s, 1800s, something like that. There's that. Yes. Orhan Pamuk. Born and had this for a very long time. I've not read this guy yet. I was thinking about getting his book, The Plague, or whatever it is. But I decided to get this one. I think this is the one he won. Oh, no. He won the Pulitzer for something else, but I think. But very excited to get this. And, oh, yes. I've been kind of getting more into action-adventure novels. I listened to James Rowland's first book of the Sigma Force series, Sandstorm. And the first place I always go to when I go to half-price books is the clearance section, because that's where I got
Me too.
Ramage, the Douglas Stewart book, which I got for $3, and I got this. Also for $3, Altar of Eden. I think James Rowland's, I think, is kind of like a Dan Brownish type of writer, but a lot better, in my opinion. And actually, I have another one. It's the second book of the Sigma 4 series from the library. So I've been getting more of those books. I just, I like, they're not literature, but they're fun to read.
And you got this one?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I've been have my eyes on this for a long time. I've seen it at Books a Million. I own a few Chabon books, but I haven't read any of them. This is him and his grandfather, I believe. I think it's... I don't think this is fiction, or maybe it's auto-fiction, but... I remember... I'm so cheap. I remember seeing this book at Books a Million for... It's on sale for $8, and I went, oh, $8, I don't know. And here it is, I waited 2 years, I got it for $3. What a steal. Saved a bunch of money waiting that long.
Right. Is that all your books?
I think so.
Great, that's our haul. So now we're going to discuss the trip from yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
What was your least favorite part of the trip?
Getting out of Pittsburgh.
Getting out of Pittsburgh.
At nighttime.
Yeah, that was... So people say moving furniture or putting furniture together test your marriage. Pittsburgh traffic tests my marriage.
Well, it wasn't traffic. It was just trying to get out of there.
Yeah, and he didn't ask for help until it was too late.
Well, it tells you... I don't know, 376 West or something like that. I was like, okay, well, I'm looking for the signs. I don't see no signs until it's way too late. And then already there's three cars on each lane going by me. So you have to go where you're going. And then we've never had that much trouble. Maybe it's because it's nighttime.
Maybe.
I don't know.
But I always drive when we leave.
Yeah. I'm better with directions.
Yes. Yes. And we went a different way because when we went to Ikea, it took us past that.
Airport Road.
Yeah. So, my least favorite part was getting out of Pittsburgh as well. What was your favorite part?
I think there should be a least favorite and most mid.
Okay, part. Then what's your most mid?
The Swedish meatballs from Ikea.
Okay.
They were very just... They were like cafeteria.
My mid was at home this time. I wasn't impressed.
I don't like
it. I think it was because it was so big.
Well, I think, like we mentioned, after seeing IKEA, it's like, well, every other furniture store is pales in comparison.
Yeah.
Aesthetics-wise, shopping experience-wise.
Yes. And your favorite part?
That's a tough one. It's either going to IKEA, that was a lot of fun, half-price books, which is always a great time, or the Indian restaurant. I've been to both of those, two of those things, like Indian restaurant, which was fantastic, and half-price books already. So I'm going to have to say IKEA.
IKEA was also my favorite. All in all, it was a good trip.
Yeah.
I would do it again. I would go to IKEA again.
I would too.
Because now I'm already thinking of other things that I want to redo.
Well, you already said when you retire, you
I want them to redo my kitchen already. Yeah. So, that's it for this video, but we will have a bedroom refresh where we're going to put together the two IKEA Ikets, as well as a new chair that I ordered and some new beds. So be looking forward to that video.
And did you see my chair?
And I will post a picture of the chair.
Oh, I'm going to put...
We will see you in the next one, and we hope you have a fabulous time.
Oh. Cheers.